Welcome to the 48th Annual Annie Awards. I'm your Annie's announcer, Dina Sherman, and I know you'll have a great time tonight as we honor the finest in animation from 2020. It's going to be an Annie ceremony like no other, so get ready for anything. Now, to get things started, please welcome actor, comedian, and the voice of Olaf in Disney's Frozen franchise, Josh Gad.
Hey, everybody. I hope you're all well and safe and ready for an Annie show like no other. I'm so honored to get the ball rolling tonight. And like I said, I'm really honored to be here. And so I'm supposed to have a co-presenter, but he hasn't logged on yet. I don't know what happened. He should be here any second. And he's great. He's terrific, fantastic. He's still not here. So, getting a chat. Okay. You want me to just read from the script as is? Okay. Yeah, sure. Let's try that, Steve. Let's try that. Hi, Josh Gad, and I'm happy to be here to present tonight's first two awards. Thank you, Hugh Jackman. You're welcome, Josh. Hey, Josh, what do you call an underwater vessel with sharp claws and a kill or be killed attitude? What, Hugh? A summer wolverine. In the category of best student film, the nominees are... And the Annie goes to La Bestia, Gobelin L'Ecole de Limoges, Marlene Van Nuenen, Rom Thomas, Alfredo Gerard Cudicott.
We are very grateful and honored for this incredible award. We would like to thank Asifa, Gobelin School, and Media One for their support. Thank you, Gerard Joseph, Mary Gerard, Jedrick, Dolcy, Cecile, Yongsan, Moira, and all our families and friends.
The lack of opportunities of where you happen to come from can sometimes make pursuing any kind of dream almost impossible. And we hope for a world where all the people can not only dream, but also get the chance to work to make it come true. And as three immigrants from all across the world, we are very thankful because we know we owe it to the people and opportunities that crossed our path.
That's why we would like to thank Guillermo del Toro, Alejandro Ramirez, Daniela Mitchell, Campus France, Plus Tom Blanchet, and Odon Valley, because without their support, we wouldn't be here tonight. And since our film is in Spanish, I would like to say, muchas gracias, querido vecino. Buenas noches.
Well, congratulations. Now on to the next category. And my second co-presenter is also not here. I guess I'll just read from the script again. Hey, Josh, I've never done an Annie Award before, but I had time to kill, so here I am. Thanks, Harrison Ford. Good to see you back on the set of Indiana Jones. This isn't a set. It's my house. In the category of Best Short Subject, the nominees are...
Mommy? quoi?
Bah, où t'as trouvé ça, toi?
Quoi, t'as un scorpion?
C'est un papy. Il a ramené ça d'Algérie.
C'est Algérie?
Bah, bien sûr, quand il a fait la guerre.
As we take to the air, I feel a familiar emotion. A deep sense that this is really where I belong.
And the Annie goes to Sylvanir, Sylvanir.
Thank you, Annie Awards, for this award. I'm so happy. Thank you very much. I want to thank all my team, my producers, my parents, Julie Nobelen, Arte, and all the people involved in this project. Thank you very much.
And now here to present our next presenter is supposed to be actress Gal Gadot, who it would appear also did not get that memo. So I guess it's up to me again. Hello, I'm Gal Gadot. It is a pleasure to be here. Who doesn't like animation? I had the time of my life on Wreck-It Ralph 2, Ralph Break, Internet. Now I would like to introduce the president of SF Hollywood, Sue Shakespeare. Thank you, Gal. Welcome, Sue.
I'm honored to welcome you tonight to our 48th annual Annie Awards celebration. It's been a transformative year for all of us, one that we'll remember for quite some time. And as the world has shifted and changed, so too has Asifa Hollywood. I'm pleased to report that this year we adapted to present our screenings, panel discussions, and special events virtually, and ended up offering more programs than ever before. We also increased our contribution to member services, such as education scholarships and grants, as well as compassionate support for our members in need. Film preservation is always one of our cornerstone pursuits, and we're about to commence on some exciting new animation preservation projects. Things have never been more exciting for animation and Asifa Hollywood. I look forward to seeing you all again in person next year at Royce Hall for our biggest celebration ever. Enjoy this special evening, and congratulations to all our nominees. It is now my pleasure to present the June Foray Award for Benevolent or Charitable Impact on the Art and Industry of Animation. This year, the award goes to animation artist and illustrator Daisuke Dice Tsutsumi. A 2014 Oscar nominee, Dice began his career at Lucas Learning, then worked at Pixar and Blue Sky Studios before forming his own company, Tonko House. But he has also found ways for art to contribute to society. In 2008, he spearheaded the Totoro Forest Project, which raised money through art auctions for the preservation of Sayama Forest, located outside Tokyo, which was an inspiration for Hayao Miyazaki's 1988 film, My Neighbor Totoro. A few years later, he oversaw an international charity art project called Sketch Travel, which sent a sketchbook on a four-year world tour, collecting original art from more than 70 artists. That brought in more than $100,000 for charity. They say charity begins at home, but Dice Tsutsumi has proven it also begins with an artist's eyes, hands, imagination, and heart. For this, Asifa Hollywood proudly presents him with the 2021 June Foray Award.
I am incredibly honored to receive June Foray Award this year. If I look at the past recipients, they're all the people that I looked up to as positive influences in this community. To be honest, I don't know what I did to deserve this, but what I can say is that I've been very inspired by this entire animation community that often go above and beyond as storytellers and artists for a greater cause in the society. And I have been fortunate to be involved with some of them. So me receiving this award represents the work of this community as a whole. I am very, very grateful. Animation is a medium of teamwork. I can never look back at my own individual achievements without supports and inspiration that I received from my colleagues. The world today is not where we had envisioned it to be as kids. So imagine how this is going to be when our children grow up to be our age. But I believe animation and storytelling can be a powerful tool to break away from this pattern. Our stories can inspire the world to be whatever we want it to be. So we can work together as one community to bring curiosity, inspiration, and dreams for the next generation. So thank you very much for this honor.
He is a four-time Annie nominee whose many animation characters include Kronk in The Emperor's New Groove and Geraldo in the upcoming animated feature film, SEAL Team. Please welcome Patrick Warburton.
Well, hello, everyone. It's great to be back at the Annie Awards. And this year, they managed to get me back without the promise of a party or food. But be that as it may, we actors, we find ourselves asked to play everything into anything. So it's all about versatility. And it's particularly fitting and accurate that tonight, SIFA Hollywood has cast me as one of the world's leading experts on production design. Most people don't realize this, but I did major in production design and expertise in college. And I was looking at some of the sketches earlier, and they all look very designy and with great production. So trust me on that. So in the category of outstanding achievement in production design for television or media production, the nominees are...
There was, however, one tradition, Aunt Lucy, that I just wasn't sure about.
Tell me again, why am I dressed up as Pidgeotton?
Oh, my. Hank, love, your bum is blocking my view.
Oh, sorry, Miss Mona. I'm hiding.
Well, I bet you could find a better hiding spot over there.
The Annie goes to Julian Bissaro for Shum's Odyssey.
Bonjour les Annie, je suis très honoré de cette reconnaissance pour The Best Production Design de Shum Odyssey et je remercie tous les membres des Annie Awards. Je félicite toute l'équipe du film, images et sons, et salue tous les autres nommés. Voilà, merci pour tout, and take care yourself.
In the category of outstanding achievement in production design for a feature production, the nominees are... Annie goes to Wolfwalkers.
Thank you, Asifa Hollywood, and thank you, animation community, for recognizing the work of myself and Ross and Maria and our whole wolf pack of amazing designers in Cartoon Saloon and beyond.
What? Oh, hello! Wow, what a surprise! Best production design, thank you very much to Tom and Maria, of course, and all the artists who made Wolf Walkers look as good as it is. Thank you very much. Bye.
I would like to thank and my family for their support.
And now to prove that versatility thing I was talking about, I'm going to present two other categories. In the category of Best Animated Special Production, the nominees are...
Who's there?
The little children lost in the woods, eh?
Fresh meat from the village, headed straight to Baba's kitchen.
Stick with it. Breathe. Slow down. And breathe.
Annie goes to the snail and the whale.
Hi there, this is the snail and the whale team here in Cape Town, South Africa, and we want to say a huge thanks on behalf of Magic Life Pictures, Triggerfish Animation, the whole crew, and on behalf of snails and whales everywhere, thank you for this awesome award.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
In the category of Best Sponsored Production, the nominees are...
Filling me with fear.
Oh, monster in the shadows, please tell me why you're here.
We're asking you to travel the vote. That means going directly to your registered polling place and voting in person, even if you're registered in another state.
And the Annie goes to There's a Monster in My Kitchen.
Thank you, Asifa Hollywood, for helping us spread the message of A Monster in My Kitchen. We partnered with Greenpeace and Mother to make this film in Cartoon Saloon just after Wolfwalkers. It's a subject so close to our heart because it's time for us to wake up to the destruction that's being wrought on our environment and our shared biosphere by industrial meat production. And I urge you all to try and think differently about the choices you make, our futures and the futures of our children and our grandchildren, and indeed the species of more than human people, depend on our actions now more than ever. So thank you all on behalf of all our crew and our partners. Thank you.
Cartoon Network Studios, we have the best besties.
Well, it was nothing really.
So, Gucci.
I'll take that applause now.
Yay, yay!
Yay, yay!
Oh, wow! Can I scream with you all, too?
Congratulations to each of our besties for their Annie Award nominations. You're the best!
Hey, congratulations to this year's nominees, including my co-creator of Big Mouth, Andrew Goldberg, and the amazing Patty Harrison on their Best Writing for TV / Media nomination.
Yes!
Last year, when everything went to hell, our crew and staff stepped up to make an animated show during a pandemic. It's an incredibly difficult feat. So congratulations to all the nominees, and most importantly, all the crews who make these shows possible.
I can't feel my face.
What do we do?
What do we say to each other?
Hey, everyone, you'll never guess what I found out!
Peace and love, Tiny and Daddy Al.
Please welcome Oscar, Emmy, Grammy, Golden Globe, and Annie-winning composer, Michael Giacchino.
Hello, everyone. Thanks for having me here tonight. I just want to start by saying thank you, and thank you for what you do. Because, you know, when I was a kid, the one thing that I wanted to be when I was growing up was an animator. Now, of course, I was never good enough to become that, but it didn't stop me from trying when I was a kid. In fact, I still have the book that I carried everywhere. This was my Bible, trying to learn how to draw, figures and different things and animals and all kinds of stuff. And I have a ton of these, which I'm sure you do too, which are flip books, where I was just trying out animation. So this one happens to have some Star Wars stuff in it. Let's just see if I can flip this correctly for you. I don't know if you can see that, Jawa. There's a lightsaber fight between Ben and Obi-Wan. Yeah, that goes really fast. But you know what? It's not that good and not that interesting. But again, thank you for all the inspiration you've given me over the years. It means the world to me. And it means a lot to me to be here tonight to announce the awards for music. So without further ado, let's get going. So in the first category for Outstanding Achievement in Music for a Television or Media Production, the nominees are...
To appreciate, it's Diwali.
And the Annie goes to Kevin Kiner for Star Wars, Clone Wars.
It's a great honor to receive this award. I'd like to thank my wife, without whom I wouldn't be sitting here. She's supported me for over 30 years in this crazy endeavor. I'd also like to thank my two sons, Sean and Dean, and also David Russell, who co-wrote much of the music in this episode. I'd also like to thank George Lucas and Dave Filoni, who entrusted me with their baby. And I'm really proud of being hired by those guys. Also, you know, I've been to a number of Annies and been fortunate enough to be nominated a few times. And I've always thought that anyone who is nominated in this category is a very special composer. In fact, I would say writing for animation is the hardest thing I've ever done in my life. And I think if you're nominated for one of these awards, it hands down means you're a great composer. So thank you to Asifa and to everyone else.
Now, in the category of Outstanding Achievement in Music for a Feature Production, the nominees are...
To you.
And the Annie goes to Trent Reznor, Atticus Ross, and John Batiste for Soul.
All right. This is fantastic. Thank you so much to everyone at Asifa. My name is Tom McDougall. I'm the executive music producer for Soul. And due to our current situation, we couldn't get Trent, Atticus, and John together. So I've been designated the one to accept on their behalf, which I am thrilled to do. And just to add that, look, music is our first passion, but to be able to do it for animation is truly an honor. So we gratefully accept this award and wish everyone a great night, and thank you.
I have two more awards to present this evening because, as we musicians say, no half rest for the wicked. Yeah, you know what? I didn't write that, and I hope whoever did is actually in traction. Yeah, anyway, in the category of outstanding achievement in character design for a television or media production, the nominees are...
Want to talk?
Talk to the glyph, witch.
And the Annie goes to Joe Sparrow for Amphibia.
Thank you so much for this Annie Award for character design. It means a whole lot to me. I feel like I can justifiably share this with the whole Amphibia crew, animation being the collaborative enterprise that it is. But I want to give special super big thanks to the storyboarders on the episode, Alex Kwan, Eddie West, In Balbreda, and Cassie Zwart. The directors on the episode, Joe Johnston and Jen Strickland. The color designer on the episode, Andy Garner Flexer. And Amy Huang for putting the whole submission for the award together and making it look really nice and lovely. Also, huge thanks to Matt Braley, of course, the showrunner, for getting me involved in the show in the first place. And just all the amazing work he puts in and just being a generally really nice guy to work for and work with. Also, personal shout out to my lovely and supporting wife, Blanca, who is working in the other room currently. Yeah, I don't know what else to say, but thank you. Just thanks.
In the category of outstanding achievement in character design for a feature production, the nominees are...
Hold on, stop. You accessorize with a sloth? I accessorize with a sloth. This is Belt.
Mine's Sash.
Ooh la la.
What should I name him?
How about Tiny Diamond?
Yeah. Tiny Diamond is my name. Come straight from my...
There it is, the Devil's Lair.
Our victory is at hand.
Gunners, fire!
And the Annie goes to Federico Pirovano for Wolfwalkers.
Fede, wake up. You won the Annie Award. Wow, thank you. I'm sincerely flabbergasted. It's 4 a.m. here in Denmark, and, whoa, I really didn't expect this with all the great competition that there was this year. So I really want just to thank Cartoon Saloon and everyone that made this great movie possible for the honor that I receive of being able to work on it. Animation, it's really a teamwork, so anything wouldn't have been possible like without the team. So I just want to thank... Tom and Ross for their vision and the trust they put on me, and all my close friends there. You know who you are. It wouldn't have been possible without you. And then to last, I just want to thank someone important in my life, my parents and my grandmas, that have always been so supportive. Vi voglio bene.
Please welcome the executive director of Asifa Hollywood, Frank Gladstone.
Hi, everyone. It's great to see you.
Frank, you're a cat.
What?
You're a cat.
I'm not a cat. What do you mean I'm a cat? Oh, I'm a cat. It's that filter thing. Hold on. How do you turn this thing off? What the? Whew. Well, there you go. Another teleconference snafu. This year, we've all experienced something like this in one way or another. Have you been in any Zoom meeting without hearing, "You're muted," at least once? And tonight, with all the possible foibles and all the possibilities, we're doing our best to bring you the Annies online. Sure, as you have seen already, it'll be different. Maybe a little glitchy, maybe somebody will be on mute. But it will be heartfelt and sincere, even funny. And because we are streaming worldwide, it may also be our biggest audience ever. We hope so. The one thing we can be sure of is that the Annies will, as it has for the last 48 years, celebrate the art of animation and the people who create it. So, congratulations to all the nominees, to those who will take home an award, and, well, to all of us for making it through this past year. Now, before I manage to turn myself into a cat again, let's continue. Each year we present the UB iWorks Award for Technical Achievement to a company or individual who has not simply pushed the envelope, they've redefined it. This year's recipient is Epic Games for its Unreal Engine. First produced in 1998 for use in video games, Unreal Engine, in a sense, belies its own name. It is a state-of-the-art, real-time engine and editor that offers its users the ultimate in photorealistic rendering, thoroughly lifelike animation, creating both traditional and interactive experiences. Not only that, it offers free tutorials and training that not only improve the engine, but also help users achieve their full potential. So let's take a look at some of the wonders created through Unreal Engine and see if you can spot the unreality. On behalf of Asifa Hollywood, I am delighted to present this year's UB iWorks Award to Epic Games for its Unreal Engine. Accepting is Epic Games Chief Technology Officer, Kim Labrary.
Thank you all. I'm honored to accept the UB iWorks Award on behalf of Epic Games, Unreal Engine, and hundreds of hardworking engineers, artists, and technical specialists from all over the planet. Our sincerest thanks to Asifa Hollywood, and especially our friends in the film and television industries, not only for putting their trust in us, but also for helping shape Unreal Engine into what it is today. Our founder and CEO, Tim Sweeney, started coding Unreal Engine back in 1995, and even back then, Tim believed in the power of building and sharing tools with artists. This dedication to enabling and inspiring creatives remains one of our core philosophies even today. And the last decade has seen a rapid adoption of real-time technology, changing the way people create content. Since 2016, over 150 films and television projects have used Unreal Engine, from pre-visualization all the way to final pixels in camera on big LED walls. We're thrilled that Unreal Engine is helping transform the entertainment industry and influencing a new generation of storytellers. And we're investing in that future, building initiatives such as the Epic Mega Grants, our Shorts program, and the Unreal Engine Fellowship. Unreal is an open source tool, and it's free for all of you to use. At Epic, we succeed only when our partners succeed, and we're super proud of all of our customers' continued achievement in animation, and it looks like 2021 is going to be the year that real-time animated content hits the mainstream. We can't wait to see what you create with the engine, and yet again, I want to thank you very, very much for this awesome award from all of us at Epic Games. Thank you.
It seems impossible that it's been 30 years since we lost the great Howard Ashman. Collaborating with his creative partner, Alan Menken, Howard wrote the lyrics for the animated motion pictures that, as they say, reawakened Sleeping Beauty. His songs for The Little Mermaid, Beauty and the Beast, and Aladdin have become classics. Those who knew Howard Ashman only through his music got an opportunity to become acquainted with the man through the documentary film Howard. The film tells the story of this musical genius's life in a truthful and affectionate way, his great achievements, his triumphs, and the ultimate tragedy of his illness and death too young at the age of 40. Here's a clip from Howard.
You're stressed. It's fine dining with
you. Yeah, the orchestration gets real big there. Maybe I should talk to Danny about pulling it down a little bit so that you are, you know, that you don't have to scream to get over it.
Well, we're separate tracks, aren't we? I mean, yeah, we can.
That's true. I just wonder if you're hearing in your cans.
Yeah. I'll play it up and play it down. We'll see how which is better.
Great. And we should get at least one on this build section. So in lump or two for you, our guest.
It's a guest. Sakes alive, and I'll be blessed. Wine's been poured and drank the Lord. I've had the napkins freshly pressed. With dessert, tea, you want tea? And my dear, that's fine with me. While the cups do this, I'll ship it. I'll be pouring, I'll be brewing.
It is a special film about a very special man. So on behalf of Asifa Hollywood, I am privileged to present this year's Special Achievement Award to the documentary Howard. Accepting is its writer and director and my friend, Don Hahn.
Hi, it's Don Hahn, and I just want to say thank you to the board of directors of Asifa Hollywood for this special honor. Howard Ashman was an amazing guy, and I think you can see that not only in his work in Little Mermaid and Beauty and the Beast and Aladdin, but also in what he gave to the animation industry and to Broadway. His knowledge of storytelling and his sense as a dramatist and a writer and a director and a producer, he was all those things. And to make a movie about his life and then have it honored by you all is just fantastic. So on behalf of his family and all of us who worked on the film, our producer, Lori Korngiebel, our editor, Stephen Yao, all the people at Disney Plus who gave us a home for the film. Thank you very much. Stay healthy and good night.
Warner Brothers Animation proudly congratulates our Annie Award nominees.
You probably can't tell right now, but I am totes overwhelmed.
Eva, looking good if I don't say so myself. Eva, but you did say so yourself.
Oh. All right, let's see how you like my bolo!
Congratulations to our talented nominees.
Is that it? Did we win?
She is the writer and director of the international hit film Abominable, and he is the co-writer and director of last year's winner for Best Animated Feature, Klaus. Please welcome Jill Culton and Sergio Pablos.
Hello, everyone. I'm so excited to be here, and I'm coming to you from Northern California. And Sergio, how are you? Where are you?
Hi, I'm in Madrid. I'm doing great. That weather looks fantastic. I envy you so much. I'm happy to be here at the Annie's, though.
So am I, and I couldn't be more thrilled to present the award for character animation. That's both of our backgrounds. That's how we know each other from. So
that's super excited. Right. Both animators, hand drawn to begin with.
Exactly.
So, you know, as animators, you and I know how essential character is in animation. And this is something that's very close to both of, you know, our hearts. This is how we got started. Anyways, in the category of outstanding achievement in character animation for a video game, the nominees are...
Close your eyes. It'll be worth it.
Okay.
And the Annie goes to Brian Weiser, Michael Yosh, Danny Garnett, and David Hancock for Marvel's Spider-Man Miles Morales.
Wow. It's incredibly humbling being among such incredibly talented nominees. First, I'd like to thank Sony Interactive Entertainment and Marvel Games for giving us this opportunity to give the world the game that it needed. We'd like to thank the entire animation team for their hard work and dedication on this project, along with everyone else at Insomniac Games for being such an incredibly collaborative team.
We strive to show the world a new perspective of being Spider-Man by looking through the lens of a new hero, as well as help normalize seeing stories about people of color, as well as other minority groups in a positive light and in an authentic way. Finally, we want to say thank you to all of our families who stood by and gave us support. Shipping a game is a monumental achievement in and of itself, and delivering the experience we made last year is a testament of the passion of everyone here at Insomniac Games. Thank you.
And in the category of Outstanding Achievement in Character Animation for Live Action Production, the nominees are...
Management changes were made. Unavoidable departmental reorganizations. However, you will be demoted.
Yeah. And the Annie goes to Nathan Fitzgerald, Leo Ito, Chris Rogers, Hyung Ho Lo, and Emily Luke for The Mandalorian.
Thank you. Yay. I'd like to say thank you, Mi Jun Jin, and my family, Yongyong, Mark, Hannah. I love you. My parents in Korea. 아빠 저 상태세요.
I just want to say thank you to my inspiration, my wife, my son, Jonathan, and also a shout out to Jeremy Masana, who should be here as well.
Thank my wife and kids for their support, Jeremy Masana and Robin Hackle for their leadership.
Thanks to everybody at Image Engine for their hard work.
Hi, everyone. On behalf of our team, we would like to thank you for this special honor. Tonight, we are so grateful to be present amongst some of the most talented artists in the industry who have also worked very hard on these films as well. It was a great experience working on The Mandalorian, and we couldn't have done it without the support and help from all our team members and supervisors at Image Engine. Thank you.
Yay!
Is that good?
In the category of Outstanding Achievement in Character Animation in a Television or Media Production, the nominees are...
Whenever a cleft is completely out of options, their final resort is to play dead.
What's wrong with your head, lady?
The idea behind the Japanese art of kintsugi is that cracks in an object are part of its history.
What does that have to do with anything?
We have to look at trauma.
You know I love my country. My real crime, my only crime, is a profound difference of scientific opinion.
You'll never get these shoes!
What were you saying?
And the Annie goes to David LaLiberté for Hilda.
Hi. Thank you so much for the award. It's an honor to receive. I'll start out by thanking the organizers of the event. I imagine it wasn't so easy to organize given the state of everything. I'd like to thank Mercury Filmworks for the wonderful 10 years of employment. Thank you so much to my wonderful partner, Jessie. She's been with me since the beginning. Shout out to my bros, Dr. Love and the Plant. Thank you so much, Mom, Dad, Aaron, for letting me pursue animation as a career. It wasn't as promising when I was starting out. Thank you to Chantal Ling, Kathleen McKinnon, Andy Coyle, Megan Ferguson, Leanne Savoy, Mercury, the Mercury Production Direction and Management on Hilda. Thank you to the builds, setup, effects, compositing, and editing departments for bringing the scenes all the way. Thank you so much.
And in the category of Outstanding Achievement and Character Animation for a Feature Production, the nominees are...
How long was the rope gone?
Oh, just like the second half of it.
I needed that rope.
Oh, but did you?
Mom, I know we've had some rough times, but you're right. I can't be truthful with you. Because it seems like no matter what I do, you disapprove.
Yeah, it's a place a father can escape the chaos of family life. Relax, hang with his bros. If bros he has.
Yeah, Barnabees!
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 Orphan!
Got away pretty fast.
You said you would help me. You promised. Go, Maeve. Take Merlin with you. Goodbye.
And the Annie goes to Michael Makarevitz for Soul.
Thank you, Asifa. While this is an individual achievement award, I can't see how I could be up here without the love and support of so many people. I'd like to thank my parents for their strength and perseverance. They came to the U.S. to give my brothers and I a better life. Thank you also for supporting me when I switched from an engineering degree to an animation degree. To my mentors and colleagues, thank you so much for continuously pushing me to be better. To my amazing wife, thank you for who you are and all that you do. Thank you for all the late hours and long days of taking care of our family so that I could put more of myself into the work. To Pete Doctor and Camp Powers, thank you for letting me be part of such a beautiful and amazing film. And for just having a nurturing, supportive, and fun environment for us to work in as artists. And thank you to everyone who has helped me and believed in me. No one does it alone, and this award is for you, so thank you.
Please welcome the producer and the Annie-nominated star of the film Wolfwalkers, Nora Twomey and Eva Whittaker.
Hello, everybody, and greetings from Ireland. Eva and I are delighted to be part of tonight's celebrations.
That's true. I've noticed there's not a lot these days that brings the entire world together, but one thing that does is animation.
And tonight, more than ever, Asifa Hollywood is living up to its name, the International Animated Film Society. So Eva, let's get started. Being a special effects artist for animation requires Talent, incredible skill, training, and the ability to create magic as though you were born with a pencil in your hand. It's no easy task, which is why those who are brilliant need to be celebrated.
In the category of outstanding achievement in animated effects for a television or media production, the nominees are And the Annie goes to Imad Khalili and Ivan Wong for Jurassic World Camp Cretaceous.
First, on behalf of the whole Jurassic World, I would like to thank the Annies because and my parents for supporting me all the time. Thank you, Margie Klein, Peter Gal, Maria Crenna, for providing us this opportunity to work on this amazing show. Thanks to Scott Kramer, Aaron Hemsey for their great leadership, Z Kang and storyboard artist, Crystal Washai, JB Bauman, art and design, Dan Godinez, animation department. Thanks to Kathy Friend for supervising lighting, CG output, and final cut. Neil Markovic for supervising all the WTV shows and Hobby. Kristen Berner and Peter McCall for managing the show. And at the end, special thanks to entire FX team and their families. We faced this episode during quarantine. We faced many challenges working from home, but we successfully kept our quality high. We couldn't finish this without these amazing crews you see right behind me. Thank you.
And I want to thank my wife and CGCG. 谢谢你. CG 动画, thank you.
Thank you.
In the category for Outstanding Achievement in Animated Effects for a Feature Production, the nominees are...
See those wolf spiders?
Yeah.
Want to ride them?
Yeah!
Thunder Sisters!
Thunder Sisters!
Thunder Sisters!
Thunder Sisters!
And he goes to Tolga Goktakin, Carl Kaplan, Hiroki Narita, Enrique Vila, and Kai Weismuller for Soul.
Thank you so much for awarding our work on Soul with the best effects for a feature. We are humbled and impressed by the great quality of work presented by all the nominees. Each one of them deserves this award just as much. Soul would not have been possible without the hard work of our directors, Pete Docter and Kemp Powers, our producer, Dana Murray, the rest of the effects team, and all the hardworking people at Pixar. We would also like to thank our families who have enabled us to work from home during these trying times. It was a long and challenging road, but hopefully resulted in a film that can offer even a small source of inspiration to those who need some. Thank you.
Çok teşekkür ederiz.
Doğum, arigato gozaimasu.
Muchas gracias a todos.
Thank you.
In the category of Outstanding Achievement in Editing for a Television or Media Production, the nominees are...
Hands up, don't shoot was for B-boys blocking jump shots. Now brown boys blocking cop shots. Instead of hoop dreams, it's now cell blocks. Instead of hoop dreams, it's now gray plots.
and out of the antique store. We said goodbye to lamp life and initiated the escape plan.
And the Annie goes to John McKinnon for Hilda.
There's so many people I want to thank. Luke Pearson, Netflix, everyone at Silvergate Media, Chantel Ling and Andy Coyle, who knew Hilda was right for our studio and fought to make it happen. Andy, thank you for trusting me to do my thing and leading with clarity and passion. And everyone at Mercury Filmworks, Megan, Vu, Mike, our storyboard team, our production team, anyone who's touched the show at all. To Brian, Brandy, and Jerry Popovich, Kyle Marshall, and of course my parents, who helped me get my footings in Ottawa, learn my craft, and hopefully be a decent person along the way. And to my wife, Kathleen, none of this happens without you being there every time I've come home late after an edit. Humoring me when I'm fired out of a cannon and supporting me when I couldn't see the light. Your belief in me keeps me going, and I love you. And to our dog, Cooper, thank you, boy, for keeping Mom company whenever I'm not around. Lastly, a year ago, the city of Ottawa lost our dear friend and beloved editor, Kevin Kovar. I miss you, Kev. This is for you.
In the category for Outstanding Achievement in Editing for a Feature Production, the nominees are...
These kids needed a change, you know? I did warn you, this story wasn't all fluffy and fuzzy. Oh, blimey, those are sharp scissors. Watch the eyes.
And the Annie goes to Kevin Nelting, Gregory Amundsen, Robert Graham-Jones, and Amara Rizik for Soul.
Thank you so much. We want to thank Pete Docter, Dana Murray, and Kemp Powers for letting us be a part of such an inspiring project. But mostly, I want to thank the three other people on this screen for bringing so much passion, dedication, and talent to what was truly a group effort, and for making this a totally enjoyable experience.
We'd also like to thank our amazing assistant editors, Eric, Aisha, Paloma, Jamie, and editorial management, Meredith, Connie, Andy, and script, Jessica and Paige.
We'd like to thank our incredible story team led by Kristen, Justin on music, the post team at Pixar, the sound crew at Skywalker, and the entire collaborative music team. Your work enriched every fiber of this movie.
Thank you also to the Soul Cultural Trust and the entire Pixar crew, visual and technical. Thank you for putting your heart and soul into every moment of this movie. Together, we met the challenge of finishing this incredibly special film as the world changed around us. Thank you.
You ready for this?
Born ready.
I got this. This is amazing!
Oh, yeah! Whoa.
This is great!
Let's do this!
No!
I know it's a lot to take in.
I only hope that we never lose sight of one thing, that it was all started by a mouse.
Just add a little fancy.
If you're out there on your own, you just might take it.
This friend business is amazing.
But if it's us against the universe, together we have been through. It's us against the
There's so much happening around here.
We win.
I love you guys.
Hey,
going to the shindig?
Huntington the Magnificent!
What if?
No, it's robots.
Love, Paddington.
Nobody lays on charm like Pony. Let's make this happen. Come on. It's working. Yes!
Good old Pony.
Congratulations to all the Annie nominees this year. I really believe that animation is the greatest art form there is. And the key to it is sincerity, believing in your character, believing in their world. When we were kids, we all played make-believe, and as it turns out, that's the magic feather we needed to become an animator. We've had it with us all along, ever since we were a kid.
To present the first of this evening's Winsor McKay Awards, please welcome legendary animation artist, Jerry Eisenberg.
Hello, Asifa Hollywood members and honored guests. I am honored to be here to introduce my old Tomodachi friend, Willie Ito, and virtually present him with a Lifetime Achievement Award. I first met Willie in 1957 at Warner Brothers, where he assisted Ken Harris. In 59, he left to join Bob Clampett on the Beanie and Cecil show, and Ken asked me to be his assistant, and I was thrilled. In 61, I went to Hanna-Barbera, and then in 1962, Bob Clampett was closing his studio, so I said to Willie, come on over to Hanna-Barbera with your portfolio, and he did, so we reunited for the next 14 years, and Willie's layout and design work was exceptional. And I learned some good design ideas from him. Then in 1975, we both left to join Sanrio Film and work on an animated feature. When that was finished, Willie went back to Disney, where he remained until he retired in 1999. But he's still very active. He's drawing and sketching all the time, and he's illustrated two children's books, Hello Maggie and Boy at Heart Mountain. And Hello Maggie is now being made into an animated short. I could tell more stories about Willie, but I better wrap this up before they bring out the hook. So let's take a look at some of the fine work of Willie Ito.
It's a beautiful night, and we call it a bella notte.
Hello, my baby. Hello, my honey. Hello, my ragtime gal. Send me a kiss by wire. Baby, my heart's on fire. If you refuse me, honey, you lose me, then you'll be left alone. Oh, baby, telephone and tell me I'm your own.
I say, you did all that great stuff. Well, I am proud to present the Asifa Hollywood Winsor McKay Award to you, Willie Ito-san.
Hey, thanks, dear, for your nice introduction. We had a great run, didn't we? I'd like to thank Asifa Hollywood and the Annie Awards Committee for this wonderful tribute. Many thanks to my mentors, friends, cohorts, and my family who put up with my long hours I spent at the studio fighting deadlines. Thanks to mentors Don Graham, Dean of Chouinard's Art Institute, and my instructors Mark Davis and Teehee. At Disney, my first assignment was to assist Iwo Takamoto, a past recipient of this prestigious award, on the iconic spaghetti kissing scene from Lady and the Tramp. Chuck Jones, Ken Harris, Fritz Freeling, and Holly Pratt mentored me at Warner Brothers' infamous Termite Terrace. I received my first screen credit as layout on Prince Violent. Thanks to Bob Clampett, a mentor, I redesigned his puppet characters Beanie and Cecil into animation. Bill Hanna and Joseph Barbera were mentors for 14 years. Thanks to my cohorts Don Jerwich, Iraj Peron, Tony Benedict, Bob Foster, and heads up to Bob Singer. Back at Disney as Director of Character Art International, I thank you, Disney, allowing me to travel worldwide on your dime to mentor young Disney artists from their home countries. Thanks also to Cindy Fortino for all of her assistance. Many thanks again to Asifa Hollywood for this awesome Windsor McKay Award. I am truly humbled.
Our next Windsor McKay presenter is Effects Animation Supervisor for Walt Disney Animation Studios. Please welcome Marlon West.
Hi, I'm Marlon West, and I'm happy to be presenting at the Stay at Home Annie Awards. Hope you bring me back another time when we're all back in the world. I'm very honored to be presenting this Windsor McKay Award, one of the highest awards given to here at Asifa Hollywood for folks that are legends in the game. And I'm particularly delighted to be giving it to a dear, dear friend of mine, Brother Bruce Smith. Bruce is a native of what they call South LA these days, studied at Cal Arts, worked on Hoop Fame Roger Rabbit and a few of the shorts afterwards. I met him on Rover Dangerfield, where I was learning how to be an effects animator. We worked on Bebe's Kids that he directed. He went on to direct the animation for Space Jam and whoop Michael Jordan's ass in One-on-One Basketball. We worked together again at Walt Disney Animation Studios on Tarzan, Princess and the Frog, a few others. He went on to create the Proud Family and co-direct Hair Love, won an Oscar.
The animator brings you to life on the page. When the drawings are viewed in sequence, they seem to come alive.
Hey, animator, what do you say we have some fun, huh?
Hey, all right. Let's go.
Come on, take.
now speaking very personally, growing up in St. Louis and starting my career in Chicago, I didn't know too many brothers that doing animation at all. Well, zero. And moving out here, meeting Bruce and a lot of other folks that he would introduce me to, really, it was an utter delight. So, Bruce, thank you so much for rolling with me for all these three decades. And congratulations, my brother.
Thank you, Marlon, for those kind words, my brother. Appreciate it. And thank you, Asifa, for blessing me with this Winsor McKay Award. Listen, I was totally taken aback and honored when you guys called me and told me I was going to receive this award this year. Completely surprised. So much so that because we're in a pandemic and I picked up this award in my mama's house. You say, why you got your mama's house? Well, because for me, this is where it all started. You know, 7-8-year-old kid right here in South Central, right in this very room, I began to really craft my love for animation. And so I have to thank my mom for continuing to support me as a child. Thanks, Mom. She heard me somewhere. I gotta thank my lovely wife and my kids for continuing to support. Also, I draft a lot of really fun information and stories from them, gleaned it, put it in my artwork. Those are the stories that kind of inspired me as I pushed through this industry. I had a lot of really great artists that really helped nurture my talent. A lot of great producers, guys like Phil Mendez, Tom Wilhite, been an amazing inspiration. Guys like Ralph Farquhar continue to inspire me today to continue to tell stories with characters and people that matter, because this is where we are right now. And I'm so glad that we got a voice in this medium, and more people are joining this medium to really help tell those stories. I expect to tell these stories for another 25 years or so. I feel like I'm just beginning. So you'll probably see me back on this stage in another 25 years, accepting this award again, not in pajamas. I'll be a little better next time. But again, appreciate you guys for giving me this, and thank you very much.
Now to present our final Winsor McKay Award of the evening, please welcome writer, artist, and director, Brenda Chapman.
Hello, everyone. Well, I'm thrilled to be able to present the Winsor McKay Award to Sue Nichols Makiorowski. It is also rather bittersweet. Sue is to me, first and foremost, my best friend. To the rest of the world, she was an incredibly talented designer, art director, and story artist who left her indelible mark on many beloved films of the second golden age of animation. Films such as Beauty and the Beast, The Lion King, Hercules, Mulan, Lilo and Stitch, and Princess and the Frog, to name only a few. In her early career before Disney, she worked on highly regarded TV shows such as Muppet Babies. I loved her Little Miss Piggies. Sue and I met at CalArts back in the days where men outnumbered women by at least 80%, which prepared her for her career to come. But those odds really didn't matter. Sue's talent was distinct and stood out even then. She was often shy and hid behind that beautiful giant smile of hers. But when it came to her art and the passion she had for the film she worked on, there was no holding her back. Her research was so thorough and her work so beautiful, all the directors knew they had gold in Sue. And on those rare occasions they opted not to use it, they had better have a darn good reason why. I know, because I was one of those directors. I had the pleasure of working alongside and watching Sue in action on Beauty and the Beast, The Lion King, Hunchback of Notre Dame, Fantasia 2000, and countless projects in development, and eventually as her director on Brave. I will forever be grateful for those memories. Now, let's take a look at some of the work of the late, great Sue Nichols.
Wow. take an idea and to find the best way to tell that in a new way, a way that's never been done before, and in a way that is best for animation, that live action could never do it this way. Only animation could do it because it's just so incredible and so imaginative.
Tragically, Soo left us far too soon, but she also left us with a wealth of artistry that will live forever. On behalf of Asifa Hollywood, I am delighted to present the Winsor McKay Award to Soo Nichols, accepting is her husband, J.R. Makiorowski.
On behalf of my beautiful, wonderful, gifted, and incredibly talented wife, Soo, I and the entire Nichols and Makiorowski families want to thank Asifa Hollywood and all those involved in bestowing this great honor on Soo. I would also like to thank John Musker and Ron Clemens for their years of vision in appreciating and utilizing the wonderful talents that Soo possessed to help create some of their most wonderful movies, especially Hercules, The Princess and the Frog, and Moana. I would also like to thank my entire family, plus Brenda Chapman, Doug Walker, Helen Dabrowski, and Soo and Eric Goldberg for helping me through these most difficult times since Soo's passing. I had a very unique perspective to be able to watch Soo work from home. Long before COVID was ever heard of, she took such pride in all the work that she did. She wanted even her rough concepts to have as much detail as possible so that she could present ideas that would help develop a story beyond its original boundaries and shed light on possibilities that no one else had thought of. It was the storyboarder, the designer, the visionary in Soo. Soo always had a brilliant smile and a sparkle in her eye that lit up the room when she walked in. She had a saying, if life gives you lemons, make lemonade. Sometimes it just takes a bit more sugar. Even through her last 6 years of metastatic breast cancer treatments, she still wanted to create and inspire. If she wasn't working on a film, she was creating set designs for the local church players or designing and building spaceships for summer Bible camp. She gave her all on a shoestring budget, working her magic and creating wonders that made people happy. She wanted to inspire others to be bright, shining stars, something we admire and look to for inspiration and direction. It is only when it is gone from our sight that we realize how special and important it is. Don't wait. Show it in the here and now so that bright, shining star knows they are appreciated and loved. Soo is a brilliantly bright, shining star, and she will continue to shine and inspire with the legacy she left behind.
Meet me.
Love you too. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, now please welcome animation voice actors and tabletop role players, the cast of Critical Role.
Thank you. I am Matthew, and with me are Travis, Laura, Liam, Sam, Ashley, Taliesin, and Marisha. Together, we are a bunch of nerdy voice actors who love to play Dungeons & Dragons. It's actually kind of a crazy story how we got together. You know what? Why don't you guys tell them?
Oh, it was actually really amazing.
Got it? Good! Okay, we are here to present the awards for voice acting and writing. First, in the category of Outstanding Achievement in Voice Acting in a Television or Media Production, the nominees are...
Incy, Teensy Beat.
No!
Okay.
Attack! I
really sorry about this.
But you're not a pet. You're not a friend. And you're not part of the family.
Hey, hang on.
You're all of those things and more. You're Pony.
Focus.
I know. I don't have time for this.
Candace?
Yeah, no, I know. I really shouldn't.
Candace!
We shouldn't. Okay, no, I know. You're right.
Freed ancient beasts, fought to save one life at the risk of countless others, because you believed every life was precious.
if that's what you mind controlled me to do.
You know what? I will. That sounds like a lot of fun. I order you to set up my karaoke machine.
Only Mumra commands me.
And the Annie goes to David Bradley for Tales of Arcadia Wizards.
Oh, wow. I want to say how honored I am to win this Annie Award. I'd like to thank DreamWorks, Magicone, the inspired and inspiring Guillermo del Toro, and it was such a pleasure working with him again. I'd like to thank everyone who voted for me, and a big hi to all the young people who follow this remarkable show. And I hope that one day my own grandchildren, Illy, Ali, Rex and Alfie, will join them. I'd like to thank all my family and friends for their love and support over the years, and a special thanks to my lovely wife, Rosanna, who, well, I'd like to thank her for pretty much everything else. This is a great honour, and I shall treasure it. Thank you very much. Bye.
In the category of Outstanding Achievement in Voice Acting in a Feature Production, the nominees are...
This is where you'll be sleeping. Now then, let's you and I get a few things straight. My name is Bella Yaga. I'm a witch.
I sure do wish I could spend the day with you sometime.
I know.
Well, there's so many things we could do. I bet it'd be really fun.
Well, let's find out.
Yeah, I mean, I'd love to.
I want my sister!
I don't like it here, all right?
My pack's all split up. There's no one to sleep all with. You will let me eat bananas? God gave Eva a rock. He kissed my hand.
Cookie ball!
When I sleep, I'm a wolf. When I'm awake, I'm me. 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 Oh, Mactira.
And the Annie goes to...
Eva Whittaker for Wolf Walkers.
Thank you so much to Asifa for this huge honor. I feel so lucky to have been a part of this film, so thank you so much to directors Tom Moore and Ross Stewart for giving me the opportunity and for always being so kind and encouraging to me. I'd also like to thank the whole Wolfwalkers team and to the brilliant Honor Neefsi, who was just the best person to work alongside. Thank you so much.
In the category of Outstanding Achievement in Writing for a Television or Media Production, the nominees are...
I found this forum for trans kids, and it was like, that's who I am. So I told my parents.
Oh God, did they freak out?
Sort of, yeah. But then my mom started listening to Lady Gaga, and sadly, that's what made her come around.
We got more kids now! Yay, yay!
Yay, yay!
But I'm your kid, though. These are my friends, so they're my kids. They're my legal responsibility.
And the Annie goes to...
Andrew Goldberg and Patty Harrison for Big Mouth.
Thank you so much to the Annies, to my family, especially my wife Colleen, who is holding the camera right now, to Ted Sarandos and all our partners at Netflix, to Chris and Shannon P at Titmouse, to our incredible cast and writers and the artists and the crew, led by Nate Funaro and Anthony Leoy, and to my partners, Mark and Jen and Nick, and most of all, of course, to Patty Harrison. Patty?
I don't have a lot of time, so this is gonna sound like I'm on coke, but I'm not on coke, I promise. I don't do coke anymore because my mom says it makes me mean. Thank you to everyone on the Big Mouth team. Thank you to Titmouse and the animators. Thank you to Josie for bringing the character to life. And thank you to everyone who watched the show. I hope this is just a start. I hope this opens doors for us to see more trans characters with storylines, not just about their transness, but storylines that extend beyond their marginalization and their transness. And I wish that for other marginalized groups as well. So thank you so much. This is awesome. I'm so honored.
In the category of Outstanding Achievement in Writing for a Feature Production, the nominees are...
Well, I owe an awful lot of that to you.
He kind of said that too.
Once you lose the person you love the most,
it changes you.
Yeah.
You can't eat dreams for breakfast, Joey.
Then I don't want to eat. This isn't about my career, Mom. It's my reason for living.
Follow me out and slay the pack of wolves single-handed?
Yeah, but we could hunt them together. Wolves, bears, dragons even.
What am I to do with you?
And the Annie goes to...
Pete Docter, Mike Jones, and Kemp Powers for Soul.
Very cool. Boy. Thank you, Asifa, for this amazing recognition. We had no idea what was in store for us as we made a film during a pandemic. Working from home has been a unique experience.
For example, thanks to Zoom, I'm really happy nobody can smell the inside of this office.
Also, thanks to Zoom, you all actually think I've read all of these props.
Thanks to Zoom, this is lunch.
This is lunch.
Which lunch today? This lunch or that lunch?
During meetings, I'm actually taking an online drawing course. Check it out.
Sometimes my dog sits in on meetings for me, and no one's even noticed yet.
Am I taking notes in this meeting, or am I shopping? You'll never know.
I've got a Roomba just for my desk now.
It truly has been a time of self-reflection.
I don't know who I am anymore.
Thank you so much for this incredible honor.
And thanks to our families, our partners at Disney, and the artists and technicians at Pixar.
And please send help.
Please take a moment to remember those who left us this past year.
please welcome the star of Broadway's Hamilton and the voice of Chung-A in Over the Moon, Philippa Soo.
Hello, thank you so much. It is such a treat for me to be here in the room where it's happening tonight, even though the room for me is my very messy office. I'm thrilled. I will be presenting the television and media production categories tonight. In the category of Outstanding Achievement in a Television or Media Production for Preschool Audiences, the nominees are...
Check this out.
Whoa. Animals see stars.
You think of it that way, the rain doesn't seem all that bad.
Thinking of things a different way is good. We call that perspective. Oh. Ah.
The jungles of Peru.
But how, Xavier? How can I do something that's never been done before?
I don't...
To the Secret Museum!
And the Annie goes to... The Adventures of Paddington. Paddington digs a tunnel to Peru.
Oh, brilliant!
What? Oh, yes!
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 We'd most like to thank Heyday Films, Studio Canal and Nickelodeon.
Head writers James Lamont and John Foster for imagining Paddington for the small screen.
Our producers Karen Davidson and Simon Quinn for all their support.
Ben Wishaw, our talented cast, our voice director Sharon Miller and composer Amin Bahafa.
And a huge thanks to the entire team at Blue Zoo for being so brilliant and patient with us.
And where would we be without Michael Bond, who gave us Paddington?
Yes!
In the category of Outstanding Achievement for a Television or Media Production for Children, the nominees are...
You've always been there for me, and you've never asked for anything in return. If this is what you want, then you should go.
My drill is out of beta!
Johnny, nice! Now put it in action!
I did! It's just for hero poses.
The Republic couldn't have asked for better soldiers, nor I a better friend.
And the Annie goes to Hilda, the deer fox.
Thank you. If you are seeing this, then that means I guess we have just won for best children's series this year, and that's pretty wild. Thanks to Luke Pearson, the creator of Hilda, Stephanie Simpson, who's the head writer on our show, Kurt Mueller, Brian Korn, everybody at Silvergate Media, Mercury Filmworks, Clint Elan, Chantel Ling, my assistant director, Megan Ferguson, all of the artists who work really hard to make this show what it is. Bella Ramsey and our entire voice cast, Oliver and Amira and Daisy, everybody. Dave Peacock, our voice director, the Swamp Man himself. I'd like to thank Ryan Carlson, who did the beautiful music in this episode, and Don at Agoraphone that does our music licensing. Nobrow, the home of the Hilda comics, where the show comes from. And finally, Dominique Bizet and Will Cartwright at Netflix. To anybody who watches this show and enjoys it, thank you so much. I really appreciate it.
In the category of Outstanding Achievement in a Television or Media Production for General Audiences, the nominees are...
We can run errands!
Turn down for what?
What?
is this face you're making?
Aren't you an inventor?
Yeah, what part of a fake acid vat with built-in air supply and quick-release bones isn't inventive enough for you? And when did my job become pitching you ideas?
Right!
Then the mental constructs.
That's your true identity.
We've just been talking about, yeah. Because all of that is just stuff that you've learned throughout your life.
And the ante goes to Genndy Tartakovsky's Primal, Coven of the Damned.
Honey? Honey?
Yeah.
Honey, you won.
Oh, wow, this is great. Well, I just want to thank Sharina Carlson for keeping this production together. Scott Wills and Christian Schellwald for doing an amazing job on all the artwork, and Stephen DeStefano and Erica Windelake for the design, Mike Lazo and everyone at Adult Swim for supporting the show, and of course, my wife and kids. Thank you.
Please welcome the Oscar-winning co-director of the animated short, Hair Love, Matthew A. Cherry.
Thank you. The experience of making my first animated film, Hair Love, gave me two things. One, of course, was an Oscar, which is really cool. And the other was just complete and total respect for all the story artists and directors who do this full time, including all the following folks. In a category of outstanding achievement in storyboarding in a television or media production, the nominees are...
Supposed to watch my favorite show, Little Country Blues.
It was the easiest way to save some money. Back me up, sweetie.
Well, we still have streaming, right?
Ad supported.
Not to worry, Doc. Now I can fit you into something real classy. Wow, you look great. Show off, Gruesome.
And the Annie goes to Andrew Dickman for Looney Tunes cartoons. Congrats.
Wow. Thank you so much for this award. I'm extremely honored to have worked on this production. They entrusted the board artists so much, and we poured our hearts and our souls into these cartoons. Real quick, I want to thank Pete and Alex for believing in me, Kenny, my amazing director, the incredible board team that I had the honor to be in the room with. I freaking miss you all. All the incredible crew that was dedicated to make these look as amazing as possible, as it still floors me when I see them. My family, my sister, niece, and nephew, especially my mom and my dad, who believed in me all my life since I started drawing and doing this crazy animation thing since I was 10 years old. I'm sure you're looking down, and I hope I made you proud. Quickly, I want to thank Ron Myrick and Carl for giving me the chance, because I wouldn't be here without you. So I just want to keep making cartoons. Thank you so much.
In the category of outstanding achievement in storyboarding in a feature production, the nominees are...
You can hear every little thing that moves. To save and your paws can hear through the air.
And the Annie goes to Trevor Jimenez for Soul. Congratulations.
Thank you to Asifa, the jury members. This is an amazing honor, and I have to acknowledge the other nominees. There's some incredible kind of legendary artists in this category with me. I'm so proud of Soul, the team I worked with, so the whole story crew were just incredible, and I don't know, working on this film for the last 2+ years was a career highlight. I want to thank Pete, Kemp, and Dana for bringing me on, and everyone at Pixar who supported the film. And lastly, thank my wife, Janine, and my daughter, Camille. My wife was pregnant at the tail end of this film, so it was just a really wild ride that I'll never forget. And what a great way to cap it off with this. This is amazing. Thank you.
Now in the category of Outstanding Achievement in Directing in a Television or Media Production, the nominees are... And the Annie goes to Jendy Tartakovsky for Jendy Tartakovsky's Prime. Congratulations.
Honey? Honey?
Yeah.
Honey, you won.
Oh, wow, this is great. Well, I just want to thank Sharina Carlson for keeping this production together. Scott Wills and Christian Chalwall for doing an amazing job on all the artwork. And Stephen DeStefano and Erica Wisselake for the design. Mike Lazo and everyone at Don't Swim for supporting the show. And of course, my wife and kids. Thank you.
In the category of Outstanding Achievement in Directing in a Feature Production, the nominees are...
Long ago, an ancient story, beautiful and kind Chung'a, and a handsome man named Ho-Yi were in love.
いつまで助けてもらえるのかな?
10年、20年、 ひなこがおばあさんになっても、 ひなこが一人で波に乗れるまで。
Let's see ya.
And the Annie goes to Tom Moore and Ross Stewart for Wolfwalkers. Congratulations, guys.
Best directors? That's crazy. Thank you, Ross. Thank you, Asifa Hollywood. Thank you, Apple, G-Kids, and our whole wolf pack. Oh!
What a surprise! Best direction of a feature. Thank you very much to of course, all the Wolfwalkers crew, our assistant director Mark Mullery, all the staff and team in 352 and Cartoon Saloon and Falivari, and of course the storyboard and editing team, especially our editors Darren, Richie, and Dara. And especially, I'd really like to thank.
He is the star of It's a Beautiful Day in the Neighborhood, who can also be heard in the animated series Archer, BoJack Horseman, The Owl House, and the upcoming animated feature SEAL Team. Please welcome Emmy winner, the ever-elegant, dapper, handsome, Matthew Rhys.
Hello?
Oh, hey, Matthew. I'm so happy you picked up. I can't do a Matthew Rhys impression, so this works out great.
What? The Annie's are tonight? Well, no, I didn't hear. Well, I would have been in the shower, but it was busy. Has it ended? Okay. No problem. No, the show will go on. Yeah. Okay, bye. Hello, my name's Matthew Rhys, and I am delighted to be here for the 48th annual Annie's, almost 49th if I hadn't been told, but I'm here quite simply to honour the best animated motion pictures of the year. In the category for best independent feature, the nominees are...
Sure, don't I look like her? And are any of the other wolves, people too?
No! Jeepers! Are you mad? How big do you think me family is?
And the Annie goes to Wolfwalkers.
Best independent animated feature at the Annies? Amazing! Thank you, Asifa Hollywood. Thank you to all our partners. Agus a big Guramila Mahagwiv to the entire wolf pack that helped make this happen.
Hello? Oh, wow! Hello! What a surprise! Thank you very much. Best Indie Awards. That's fantastic. This award is really for everyone who worked on Wolfwalkers, everyone in Cartoon Saloon and Studio 352 and in Falivari, and of course everyone in Apple. So thank you very much.
From souls to trolls, from jazzmen to cavemen, from a family marked by elfishness to a family marked by selfishness, the most brilliant of this year's animated features showed us the world from every possible angle. And if there ever was a year when we needed to be in different worlds, 2020 was it. In the category for Best Feature Film, the nominees are... And the Annie goes to Seoul.
Wow! Thank you, Asifa, for this honor. We are so grateful to our amazing cast, including Jamie Foxx and Tina Fey. Right, Dana?
Get it,
Dean.
Thank you for our amazing Seoul crew. Thank you to Michael Giacchino, Jasmine Simon, and Michael Ford. You guys are all the best. Isn't that right, Dan?
Thanks to Mike Jones, Kevin Knowlton, Kristen Lester, and Trevor Jimenez. You guys are all amazing. And of course, thanks to all of our families who stuck with us and supported us while we got this film completed. Isn't that right, Keith?
What?
I said, thanks to all of our families.
What?
Yeah, I think we took this social distancing thing a little bit too far.
So that's it for the 48th Annual Annie Awards for the first and hopefully last time virtually. To all our winners and nominees, enormous congratulations. And until next year, take care, wear your masks just a little while longer, and a very good night to you all.
Muchas gracias, querido vecino.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Merci pour tout.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Asifa Hollywood.
Thank you to Asifa and to everyone else.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Wow. Thank you.
Thank you very, very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Many thanks.
Thank you very much.
Thank Asifa.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I just want to keep making cartoons. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
What a surprise. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Asifa Hollywood.